Well, welcome everybody to Merrimack High School's 2022 Boys Varsity Senior Night. Thank you all for coming and helping us celebrate these fine young men who have given so much of themselves for the love of soccer and to Merrimack High School. Now we would like to introduce the Merrimack High School Class of 2023 Varsity players. First up, Tyler Barnard. Tyler is joined on the field by his father, Steve, his mother, Karen, and his brother, Joshua. Tyler's favorite soccer memory was his JV team's comeback against BG to keep our undefeated season alive. After high school, he plans on attending a four-year college on the East Coast to study business. Tyler would like to thank his family, friends, coaches, and teammates he had along the way for making MHS soccer a great experience. Next up, we have Tawan Berger. Tawan is joined on the field by his mom and dad. Tawan's favorite soccer memory was singing Party in the USA after a dub. After high school, he plans to attend college. Tawan would like to thank his parents, friends, and coaching staff. Next up, Colby Chasen. Colby is joined on the field by his mom, Carrie, dad, Mark, and his brother, Zach. Colby's favorite soccer memory was the time he scored the goal versus BG sophomore year to lead to a comeback win to stay undefeated. After high school, he plans to attend college somewhere in New Hampshire to study sports management. Colby would like to thank his parents, his brother, for pushing him to where he is today, and he can't thank them enough. Next, we have Brandon Obriga. Brandon is joined on the field by his mom, Rose, and his dad, Nate. Brandon's favorite soccer memory was playing with Stephen G his freshman year. After high school, he plans to attend college. Brandon would like to thank Tobias Warner. Next, we have Danielle Sanchez. Daniel is joined on the field by his mother, Lisa, and grandparents. Daniel's favorite soccer memory was scoring the winning goal against Goffstown in his junior year. After high school, he plans to attend college and get his bachelor's in cybersecurity. Daniel would like to thank his mom for pushing him to be the person he is today. Next, we have Tobias Warner. Tobias is joined on the field by his mom, Ramona, his dad, Michael, and his brother, Florian. Tobias's favorite soccer memory was being able to share the field with his brother. After high school, he plans to attend a college and continue playing soccer there. Tobias would like to thank his family, friends, and coaches for helping him along the way. And finally, we have Owen Cleaver. Owen is joined on the field by his parents, Karen and Jake, and his sister, Avis, and girlfriend, Molly. Owen's favorite soccer memory was singing on the rides home. After high school, he will attend college to study business. Owen would like to thank his coaches, Mursad, Huzi, and Pap, and his parents for all the rides. And ladies and gentlemen, how about a final round of applause for the Merrimack High School class of 2023 Varsity Soccer Players. Congratulations. Okay, as we get ready to roll this evening from Tomahawk Sports Central, girls varsity over Goffstown, 3-1. Having said that, good evening and welcome to Merrimack High School for tonight's boys varsity soccer game between the Grizzlies of Goffstown High School and your Merrimack Tomahawk. This game is being played according to the rules set forth by NHIAA and its member schools. We ask that you, our fans, help make today's game a memorable experience for our athletes by showing good sportsmanship towards all players, coaches, and game officials throughout the contest. Inappropriate language, taunts, or other demeaning actions are grounds for removal from the game. As a reminder, no fans are permitted on the field at any time. In case of an emergency, please vacate the premises by the nearest exit at each end of the stadium. The officials for today's game are Andrew Brodier and Jeff Phillips. Now let's meet the starting lineups. First, for the visiting Goffstown Grizzlies, we have number one, David Dalila. Number three, Devin Philippi. Number five, Cole Osborne. Number six, Brody Reeves. Number seven, Jake Bates. Number 10, Hunter White. Number 11, Austin Morin. Number 12, Jordan Fisk. Number 13, Harrison Vaughn. Number 17, Lucas Bugudi. And number 17, Grayson Varga.
Oh, no kidding.
Now for your Merrimack Tomahawks. The Tomahawks are coached by Mursad Islamovic and assisted by Ray Juno and Mursad Jusovic. Mursad J. Sorry. Starting lineup is number 12, Ben Pasoli. Number 3, Brandon Nobriga. Number 21, Colby Chasen. Number 26, Daniel Sanchez. Number 1 and number 25, Drew Flanders. Number 24, Isaiah Treveras. So. Number 16, Owen Cleaver. Number 11, Quinn Ioannio. Number 7, Tuan Berger. Number 15, Tobias Warner. And number 6, Tyler Barnard. My apologies if I messed up any names. Don't shoot the messenger. At this time, we would ask that everybody please stand, remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of the national anthem. Tonight's guest singer is Jennifer Epstein. Thank you, Jennifer. Beautifully done.
Nancy. Never mind.
Well, here we are, Mark.
Yeah, good evening to everybody. Welcome to Merrimack TV's live coverage of Merrimack Tomahawks against Goffstown.
Jennifer Epstein singing the national anthem. The kid's
got a lovely
set
job.
Of pipes.
Did a lovely job on a very difficult song to sing
not
without
easy.
Accompaniment.
No, and not only that.
Acapella.
She didn't muck it up with all the interpretational type stuff.
It was
she sung
a true
it.
Rendition.
She sang it clean and true. Just lovely. Lovely.
And we are underway here at Merrimack Stadium. A little bit chilly this evening, 57 degrees. Expected to drop a bit lower as the game goes on.
Can't complain with that 57 degrees, though.
That was beautiful today.
It's a clear, cool
once the rain
night.
Stopped, of course. Andrew and I were speculating whether or not today's game would be able to happen due to field conditions, but we're happy to see that it is underway.
Oh,
that was Tobias Werner on defense for some early action with a defensive throw going on.
Yeah, the
looks
field's
like it's going to be taken by Tuan Berger.
Field's starting to get a little beat up this time of year.
It looks a little tired this time of year, for sure. Merrimack is attacking from left to right on your screen. Goffstown is attacking from right to left. Merrimack in their home blues. Goffstown sporting their away whites.
We are perched once again high atop the Merrimack Municipal Stadium press box. Bringing the game to you this evening.
We'd like to welcome everybody who's watching, both in Merrimack and in Goffstown. Our friends at Goffstown TV are simulcasting this game for their community as well. And, of course, we'll talk about some streaming options later during the game.
Well, Mark, it's been a little bit of a disappointing season here for Merrimack Tomahawks boys team. They've come in with a current record of 2 wins, 11 losses, and 1 tie. During those 14 games, Merrimack has scored 9 goals while allowing 27. Despite that, they find themselves facing a Goffstown team in a similar situation with a record of, I believe, 3-9-2.
3-9-2 is accurate, yes.
I believe that if Goffstown has any chance of making the playoffs, that they'll need a win in tonight's game.
Tonight is senior night for Merrimack Varsity Soccer. Each of the players introduced at the beginning of the game with their supporting family units and friends. It's always nice to see.
You'll notice on the field, which we've already mentioned, a little tired in the middle of the field there, but you'll notice this two sets of lines. You have your white lines and you have your blue lines. The white lines, of course, are for American football.
Merrimack mounting an attack now. Looking promising. Ben Basoli takes the shot. Oh, it's a cross and no connection. It almost looked like he was going to make connection with Colby Chasen in the end.
But you'll notice the white lines are football. You can pretty much ignore them. Notice the football field's a lot narrower than a soccer field.
The blue lines are proper football.
Yes.
As opposed to American football. Goffstown clears that ball out into Merrimack's third. Merrimack trying to put something together now and mount a new attack. And they play back to keeper Drew Flanders, who pops it right back, and Merrimack is trying to get going here again. There's a good searching ball. A little too heavy a touch, lands closer to the Goffstown player, but he shuffles it out for a Merrimack throw. That throw taken by Isaiah Traverso. I think I misidentified him as Tawan Berger moments ago. I think that's Tawan on the far side of the field. Merrimack trying to put some things together. Goffstown connecting some passes now and sending the ball the other way. Goffstown's defense playing a high line toward midfield. And it's out for a Goffstown throw. Merrimack's defense stepping back a little bit, trying to keep a high line to draw the offsides. Oh, that's a good through ball. But Merrimack is there. Oh, they try to shut it down. And Goffstown gets a piece of that and sends it back to another Goffstown player. And they're looking to put something together here. And Goffstown with another throw. Merrimack's defender a little worse for the wear after that action.
Strong play from the right wing on Goffstown.
It's a good throw by Goffstown. Merrimack trying to break up this play. Ball gets sent into the box, and it's scooped up by Drew Flanders. No one there to help Goffstown put that one in the back. Now we've got Tobias Werner coming down. Tobias, one of the seniors that was honored tonight. He's got lots of room to run here, and he sends a cross through. Unfortunately, that does not find his intended target. And Goffstown trying to reverse the play. Merrimack says, nope, not right now. And that's going to be out for a Merrimack throw. Merrimack trying to put something together in this early action. 5 minutes underway already. Play showed some promise. Winds up with a Merrimack corner kick.
Oh, I did not realize. Apparently the goalie got a piece of that.
Yeah, it looked like it just kind of went wide. I guess he didn't get a very big piece, but it seems that he did. Merrimack with numbers in the box. Decent cross in, crawling toward the goal. A header, and that goes wide.
Just wide.
Almost a goal by Tobias Werner, who's now sprinting back to cover his defensive slot.
Good header, good bid. See if he can do that again.
Goffstown's goalkeeper taking a goal kick.
And that's short.
A little bit short. Goffstown maintains possession. Pop it really high out to midfield. Tobias Werner heads that forward for Merrimack. And Goffstown now taking over, but they send that ball long. Tobias Werner sprinting back. Drew Flanders in the right position to scoop that one up. Rolls it out to the left side. And Ben Basoli now sprinting down the field. He's got a defender with him. Fancy footwork by Ben. He unloads and gets rid of the ball.
Goffstown really
leaves. Shot from way outside.
Goffstown really leaves a lot of room on the wings there for those outside backs to dribble up after a goal kick. Or
they do. Yeah, I think they're going to need to mark up a bit if they're going to keep Merrimack contained.
Yeah, at this point, I think that's what I'd do every time if I were Merrimack. Play it out wide in the back and let them range forward.
Merrimack's defensive line way up now. And Drew Flanders right at the top of the 18. Merrimack breaks that play up. Ben Basoli now looking around for his options. Merrimack with some good passing now, trying to set something up. Heavy touch by Werner. Maintains control. And nice pass, give and go. Beautifully executed. And broken up by Goffstown right at the top of the box. Tobias Werner now putting his wheels on to get back. And Tobias sends that out for a Goffstown throw.
Huh. I thought that was off the Goffstown player, but as we've mentioned before, we are quite a distance away from the field up here, so.
I could actually, from up here, I could hear the second touch as it left Tobias' foot and hit the player either in the foot or the shin guard. It was Harrison Vaughn from Goffstown trying to put something together.
I smell food, Mark.
I do too, and it smells really, really good.
I'm looking around here. Oh, you know what it is. It
smells like a cheesesteak.
I think those JV kids got themselves some pizzas.
Nice.
Oh, that's some.
Goffstown slides that one, quite literally slides that one over. It's going to be a Merrimack throw. Merrimack pushing numbers forward now. Ball's inbounded. Back to Werner. That ball deflected.
Fortuitous deflection.
Still finds the feet of Merrimack's number 26.
It's almost like he planned it that way, Mark.
That's Daniel Sanchez. One of his early touches for the game. Ref calls Goffstown throw. Looks like Merrimack's lining up some potential substitutes at the center line. Goffstown now with some numbers forward and some opportunity. Space to take the shot. I don't think he got the piece of that he was hoping for. Merrimack's able to clear that out to midfield. Ten minutes into the action here, and the score remains 0-0. You're watching the Merrimack Tomahawks against the Goffstown Grizzlies. We'd like to thank you for watching today's event on Merrimack TV, and as it turns out, also on Goffstown TV, who's sharing this broadcast. If you're interested in learning more about Merrimack TV, email Nicholas or Justin at MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov. Again, that's MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov. We'd like to thank the folks in Goffstown for sending this broadcast out on their network. It's nice to see cooperation amongst all these local stations.
bit of jostling going on there in the middle.
Jostling, a play whistle dead, and it's going to be Goffstown over the ball. Merrimack dropping their defense and midfielders back, leaving only one man up top, Ben Basoli, in case the play turns around. Goffstown with six people moving toward the box now. That's Brody Reeves over the ball for Goffstown. Brody, one of the Goffstown captains. That ball headed down. Good opportunity. Almost found Austin Morin from Goffstown.
Drew Flanders getting on his horse there.
Drew Flanders took care of that.
Avoid the corner kick.
Managed to keep that ball inbounds.
Good hustle play there.
As we discussed last week, the ball can stay in and the goalie can slide out like that as long as the ball stays inbounds. The ball is still in play. Goffstown with an opportunity now.
All right, it's not like basketball where it matters where your feet are. It's just where the ball is.
Goffstown, some heavy pressure from Merrimack in the midfield, and now they get this forward. Merrimack with six defenders back. Goffstown with only three people forward right now. And got a little extracurricular on the field for a Merrimack kick. Tobias Werner is going to take that one. It's Isaiah Traverso involved in the play that earned the foul. A couple of subs for Merrimack now. And it looks like one for Goffstown. Tobias sends that ball right to the top of the 18, headed down by Goffstown. Goffstown trying to put something together now. Harrison Vaughn pushing forward for Goffstown. That's broken up by Merrimack. It was Caden Martin for Merrimack.
Ooh.
That ball shouldered. And that ball pushed in right to the top of the box on the outside corner. And that gets sent to midfield and pounded right back forward. Goffstown first to that errant attempt at controlling. And now Merrimack trying again here. Ball still in bounds. And the attempt at the cross, he couldn't get his hips around. That ball goes behind the goal for a Goffstown goal kick.
See if Merrimack can win this thing in the air. Bring it right back at him.
The 50-50 balls seem to be going about 50-50 tonight. Got shouts of encouragement from the Merrimack fans. That ball kind of won by Merrimack. It ricocheted around between a few players, but Goffstown sends that one out of bounds. Stop the play and get some numbers back. Ben Basoli with the throw for Merrimack. Flick on header. Right to the top of the box again, and then pounded to midfield again. I think we've seen this play a little bit. Merrimack just trying to get in there, and Goffstown holding their line at the top of the box. Goffstown the first of that ball. That's a good searching ball down the wing, but Tobias Werner's there, unable to keep it inbounds, but he does break up the play for a Goffstown throw-in. It's going to be a foul on Merrimack. It was number nine, Adrian Talbot. A little shoulder charge there. Goffstown finding a nice piece of grass from which to take that kick.
Yeah, the grass is still pretty good out on the wings.
It is. That's the non football playing surface.
Yeah.
That ball into the box, headed on, and Drew Flanders there to pluck that out of the air. And he sends that punt forward. Half field, but it pops over the head of his intended recipient. Tobias Werner sprints forward to try to control that for Merrimack. Merrimack still trying to put something together here. And, well, there's a dangerous ball. Tobias Werner lucky to get there just in the nick of time.
A little bit of pinball going on now, back and forth.
As we're standing up here commentating, I got a call from a former Merrimack varsity soccer player.
Oh, good.
Had to text him and tell him we're in the middle of a broadcast and we'll get back to you later. Which means he'll probably tune in now. He does enjoy watching these games of his alma mater. Goffstown trying to put something together here.
Ooh. I don't know about that one.
That ball's whistled dead. That was
there's a little extracurricular activity going on there.
Little shove. Just a little.
Goffstown player helped the Merrimack player along with his momentum.
He did indeed.
Provided a helping hand.
That ball sent way over the end line for a Goffstown goal kick. The former player in question looking for help on his Java programming assignment.
Java. I remember studying Java about 30 years ago.
He's lucky that that is in my bag of tricks. Got the ball pushed out almost to midfield, but we've got a handball on Merrimack. Oh, no, they called it on Goffstown. What do we got going on here? The ref is questioning the spot for the kick, so it was on Goffstown. It looked like a Merrimack hand, but I guess it deflected off Goffstown. And Merrimack pounds that ball into the box and right into the hands of the keeper. That was Quinn Giuliano over the ball. Goffstown's towering punt comes out way past half field. And that ball is sent sideways. Merrimack struggling to keep it in. Manages to do so. I believe that was C.J. Fricano keeping the ball in for Merrimack. And Merrimack earning a throw. Isaiah Traverso to take the throw. That ball was thrown in to Adrian Talbot. Merrimack still trying to put something together. Broken up by Goffstown now. Merrimack pressuring hard in the transition between the middle and final third. Broken up by Goffstown, sent out to midfield. We've got a 2-on-5 situation, now 3-on-5.
Merrimack's got a lot of bodies back there.
Merrimack breaks that play up adeptly. That was Daniel Kovarzhensko over the ball to break up that play. Daniel, a freshman for the Merrimack team.
From the Ukraine.
Yes. We're looking at the rosters pregame, Andrew, and I noticed that there are no seniors on the Goffstown roster.
That is a bit of an oddity, is it not?
It is a little unusual. A lot of juniors. Some freshmen, some sophomores, but no seniors, which is kind of surprising. Merrimack with 7 seniors on their team. Goffstown trying to put something together now, sprinting for the ball. Tobias Werner manages to shepherd that over the line for a Merrimack throw. That was Elijah Dillaway for Goffstown, part of the class of 2024, which would make him a junior. CJ Fricano keeping that ball in bounds. Manages, he did not manage to keep that one in. He slid and tried to keep that from going over, but no indeed. And the throw-in taken by a Goffstown mystery player whose number is not on their roster, number 19. So I'm guessing my roster is not up to date. That ball thrown.
Maybe he's a senior.
Maybe he is. Hadn't thought of that. Oh, a nice little flick pass. Merrimack broke that up before it could become too much of a problem. And here comes Goffstown again. 50-50 ball there. Won by Merrimack. Quinn Giuliano. And Goffstown tries to break that up, manages to kick it straight out from the box. Merrimack recovers, still trying to get some momentum building. Isaiah Traverso
played ball.
Isaiah Traverso still drops back, try to make something happen. And that ball was sent out by Daniel Kovrzenko. Goffstown with a substitute. Coming off, Harrison Vaughn. Coming on is Luca DeMarco. Goffstown's throw. And Goffstown off to the races. Tobias Werner breaks that one up. And ball's popping around the midfield quite a bit. Now Merrimack with control. Sends it only as far as a Goffstown defender, who sends it as far as a Merrimack attacker. Ben Basoli on the outside. And that's going to be whistled as a foul. Goffstown.
A little chuck there.
Just a little. Little
I don't know if I would have called it.
Hey, I'm in your space.
Right. Yeah, he did let him know he was there, no doubt.
Goffstown pushes that one forward past midfield. Headed down by a Goffstown player. And some mighty speed from Goffstown at the moment as they're looking to cross that in. It's broken up. And it's going to be a Goffstown corner. Now, just about 25 minutes into the action. That ball curled in nicely. Oh, and Drew Flanders right there.
Yep.
Scoops that one up.
Good play, Drew.
Enjoying the game? Check out more MHS sports action from Merrimack TV on your Roku, Apple TV, or Amazon Fire TV device. Download Cablecast to watch your next game live or previously recorded games on demand. You may also discover over 100 programs from Merrimack TV. Meeting coverage, local news, community shows, school events, and so much more. Download Cablecast to your Roku, Apple TV, or Amazon Fire TV device. This is Merrimack TV. This is your voice. Oof. Merrimack trying to put something together, but broken up by Goffstown in the box. Merrimack still trying to get the ball back into the box. Goffstown applying a lot of pressure. Goes forward to Tobias Werner, who's trying to turn the play around now. And manages to do so. And Ben Basoli now. Some fancy footwork. But Goffstown manages to step in and take that away.
Merrimack seems to be carrying the play so far, but not a lot to show for it in terms of we're still knotted at 0-0.
Well, there's a good-looking shot. Ooh. Oh, Goffstown's goalie stretches out for a really nice two-handed save, pushes that over the line for a corner kick.
It's difficult to tell from this angle if that was on frame or...
It was a little difficult. The goalie taking no chances either way.
Exactly.
But what
a quick shout out to the folks at Merrimack TV who are broadcasting tonight's game live. Your award-winning Merrimack TV's holding an open house this Thursday at Town Hall, 6:30 to 8 o'clock. Stop by, check it out. See what goes on behind the scenes to bring you this live action.
Merrimack with the corner, in swinger, headed away by Goffstown. And push forward to half field. And Goffstown unable to connect with that properly, and Merrimack turns it around quickly. Merrimack with numbers still forward as a result of that last play. Now Goffstown coming down. Got four players looking for something here. Merrimack's defense holding a high line. Drew Flanders tracking back in his goalie box, making sure he's in the right position. Goffstown putting something together now. Nope, broken up by Merrimack. Pushed forward by Goffstown again. And that ball in right to the top of the box by Goffstown. Tobias Werner sends that down the line. Merrimack's Daniel Sanchez trying to control. Tawan Berger involved in that play as well. That's Tawan in the corner now. Goffstown turning that around. Both teams with some decent ball movement. Neither team able to find the back of the net so far. And that ball's going to go out for a Merrimack throw. A throw taken by C.J. Furcano.
Neither team marking very closely right now. It seems like there's a lot of time and space to work with.
Seems like there's a lot of space, yeah.
It's like they're playing on a field twice the size as usual. So there's a lot of space in the midfield for them to move the ball. Both teams kind of sitting back a little bit.
C.J. Furcano inbounds it, and it's headed out yet again. We're down to 54 degrees, and the temperature continues to fall. And one more throw by C.J. Furcano. Merrimack struggling to keep that ball in the box to try to put something together. Sent over by Goffstown. That was Adrian Talbot trying to turn the corner in the box. The attempted inbound deflected off of Goffstown, and they're managing to put something together now. Numbers coming forward.
They still have a lot of tricks.
That's a dangerous cross, but...
Seems like Goffstown has some trouble getting bodies forward. If you look, there's only, you know, when the attack hits, there's only,
yeah, there's only
three or four players
at most
up there.
And they're up against a pretty successful goalie, Drew Flanders. So it's,
with
those numbers forward, it's going to be a little tricky for them to find one.
Very quick.
Very quick. Very, very wiry. And
agile.
It's like a puma ready to pounce.
Like a cat.
Merrimack with a direct kick from roughly midfield. And that ball finds its way into the box, headed down by Goffstown. Goffstown trying to get some numbers forward now. And that ball's cleared out very
Sanchez
adeptly.
Sanchez with the slide.
By Daniel
tackle.
Sanchez.
Fans getting a little restless out in front here.
I'm just glad the JV team seems to have finished whatever they ordered because I can't smell it anymore.
No,
quite hungry.
They didn't bring any up to us, so not sure. I'm sure if they had something, they would have brought us some, Mark. So it must have been someone else.
It must be it.
Those kids wouldn't do that to us.
That's going to be called for a Merrimack throw. That was a bit of a dangerous ball.
It was, but it worked out.
Adrian Talbot sends that one forward. Goffstown's trying to turn it around now. Got a Goffstown throw. Got about 8 minutes remaining in this particular half.
I think some of the girls from the game at Goffstown have arrived to cheer on their... Oh, that's a little bit of danger.
That was danger. A little bit of danger. Ref says play on. Ball sent only to half field. Pop forward by Goffstown again. For those of you watching at home, you may have heard the booming voice of the stadium announcer Gary talking about Community Media Day. Well, Merrimack's Town Council proclaimed this Thursday to be Community Media Day.
How about that?
Community media connects you with your neighbors, community organizations, schools, and local government. Watch for special programming throughout the week and join us for an open house from 6:30 to 8 p.m. in the Merrimack TV studio at Town Hall, 6 Babusick Lake Road, on Community Media Day, Thursday, October 20th, 2023.
Assuming he got the ball first because there's no foul.
And as we're talking about community media, I'd like to mention once again, say thank you that Goffstown is also broadcasting this game from Merrimack TV.
Oh, that's, ooh. Yep. Was a good idea.
A little overcooked on the pass for Goffstown.
A little bit heavy touch, but.
Finds its way outside.
But there was space there for sure.
Got a Merrimack throw. Headed down by Goffstown. Oh, this could be risky for Merrimack. And that ball sent forward right on the keeper, so not.
Definitely handled by Drew.
Not too much concern for Drew.
No.
But that was a risky opportunity for Goffstown that could have cost Merrimack.
It looked like there was a man there about the top of the 18 ready to make a run in.
Werner sends that forward. Merrimack tries to cross that one in. Nothing goes way out of bounds. It's going to be a Goffstown goal kick, a couple of substitutions for Goffstown coming in, one for Merrimack. Looks like, is that CJ Fricano stepping over the...
Oh, I think that's Sanchez. I think that's Daniel Sanchez.
And on comes Brady Toll, number 14. And clock stops at 5 minutes, as is the way it runs in high school soccer. From this point forward, the ref keeping official time, including any stoppage. Goffstown unable to keep that in. Throw in for Merrimack. Taken by Toll.
Hard tackle there a moment ago by our friend Daniel from the Ukraine. A little bit.
That ball played back to Werner. A little soft. It looked like that could have been risky. Werner sends that forward.
A bit of a limp right now. On, I think his last name is Kovienko, something like that.
You're close. It is Kovershenko.
Yeah. Ooh. I would call that. That to me was a foul, but.
Werner sprinting back, sends that sideways, not far enough to clear it completely. And Goffstown comes in and. Tobias can't find the handle, can't manage to keep it in bounds.
Tobias covered a lot of ground there.
Got about 4 minutes remaining in this half. Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Oof. Oof.
Wind's picking up just a touch here. And the dew is definitely settling in because my papers are quite wet.
They are damp.
Goffstown trying to find the opportunity.
Just too many bodies there for...
A lot of traffic for them to try to get
like
through.
There are like seven guys back there.
Ben Basoli trying to make something happen on the right wing now. And dispossessed. Goffstown now trying to mount the attack. It's a good looking ball forward. I don't think he got the touch on it that he wanted for Goffstown. But certainly tried to get it back. Unfortunately, it found the sidelines for Goffstown, so Merrimack throw. We're still tied 0-0 here at Merrimack Stadium. Got a decent turnout from both Merrimack and Goffstown in the stands.
Yep. Really good crowd here for Merrimack as it's senior night. Being farewell to this year's seniors. I think this is their last home game. They have
Goffstown
one more
throw.
Against Nashua South, but I think that's at South, if I'm not mistaken.
And Merrimack with a long throw, broken up by Goffstown, and neither team able to find a true possession just yet. Now Goffstown has one, and nope, that one had some pace on it, unable to be handled by Goffstown's offense, and out it goes for a Merrimack throw. Got about 2 minutes until halftime. Merrimack and Goffstown both looking to break open the scoreline here. Neither team so far able to do so.
Merrimack had one nice shot that, from up here, it's difficult to tell whether it was on frame or not, but certainly diving save by the Goffstown goalie. So it was close. If it wasn't on frame, it was close. Probably their best opportunity thus far tonight. I don't know that Drew's been tested all that much with any really super difficult shots to make saves against. He's
Merrimack getting called back about 20 yards on that throw-in. I think they got a little ambitious where they tried to take it from. Ref got the spot right.
You can always try, right?
Tobias Werner not able to put a handle on that one to bring it down.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a trip.
A little bit of a trip. And it's going to be Merrimack kick. Goffstown dropping numbers into the box, holding a high line.
From about 30 yards, a little over 30 yards.
They're going to stay outside the 18 to try to get that ball inbounded and draw Merrimack off sides. So the timing of this is going to be tight. And actually, the 10-yard wall is going to be right pretty close to where their defense is tracking anyway. Goffstown going with a two-man wall.
30 yards out. That'd be a heck of a shot if he made it.
That ball gets sent high and away for a Goffstown goal kick. And that's going to be halftime here in Merrimack. You're watching Merrimack TV, where the score remains 0-0, essentially zero stoppage time. There was not a lot of reason for it, so both teams now will try to regroup and figure out their strategy for the second half.
Like the girls team is going to go out there and kick the ball around.
And looks like some guys at the other end as well.
Guys, maybe the football team who just finished practice.
Could be.
A little while back.
Could be. It's definitely getting a little chillier out here.
Yep.
I think I am not sufficiently layered this evening.
Definitely, you know, I debated whether I should bring the winter coat, and I usually make a poor decision and do not. And then I'm upset with myself later. Tonight, I showed a little good judgment and brought the coat with me.
I just have a little shell on, and my winter jacket is safely ensconced in my vehicle in the parking lot.
It's right where it belongs.
I'm fine. It's going to get chilly tonight, and I guess for the next few nights. I finally caved and turned my heat on yesterday.
Trying to avoid that. I'm trying to. My house is like a meat. You could hang meat in my house.
We were
right
down
now
to 59 degrees. Yeah. And so yesterday I flicked the switch, and the heat doesn't work.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
What happened?
We're not sure yet. I had my guy come out today, and he took a look, and of course it instantly worked.
Of course.
It was just his aura, I think, that got me back up and running. He's pretty convinced that I need two new thermostats, which is a pretty cheap solution.
Pretty,
if that's
pretty
the problem.
Easy. That's the best. So that's the best news you can get, Mark.
He was going to come back tomorrow to get those installed. He called me and said, "Well, they're not available till Thursday. I'll see you then."
So, oh, Mark. Jesus.
So it's going to get a bit brisk in the old House of Berg.
Just head to the old Home Depot. Make do a little do-it-yourself action.
Well,
there, Mark.
I have incentive to get him to come back to do this, though. 6 years ago, he was supposed to install a sink in my basement.
Ah.
And he got busy. And then, of course, we had the pandemic. So
right.
I am happy to have him do the thermostats if it means I get my
basement sinks.
My slop sink in the
awesome
basement.
They are awesome.
That's what?
I'm guessing it's below grade, so you got to have some sort
pump
of pump to get the. Yep. That's the problem.
Yep. I've had the sink and the pump and the faucet sitting there
for six years. We could do a little This Old House type show, Mark.
We could.
Although your house is pretty new, so.
Yeah, it's 20 years old.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. I thought it was newer than that.
And it's definitely starting to show its age with repairs here and there.
Yeah. Now, you guys didn't build it. There was someone in there before you, right?
That's correct, yes. Yeah, we were the builders of our previous house, which was only 0.4 miles away in Merrimack. So you'd think, oh, 0.4 miles, that'll be a simple move.
No.
Yeah, everything that could have gone wrong certainly did.
Yeah. It's not the distance between. It's getting everything in and out of the trucks. That's
it's the trucks, yeah. The movers managed to drop my drill press on the driveway
and damaged
that. And the person that estimated the move got way too small a truck, so they had to bring a second one. It was very exciting.
Yeah.
When we finally got there, I said, "I am never moving again. They can bury my body in the woods behind the house."
That's right. Yeah, it's been in our house for over 20 years now. And luckily, when we moved in, we were young newlyweds, so we didn't really own anything. Or we didn't own much.
That is the way we moved in as well.
There were a lot of empty rooms.
Our first house, yes.
It was a pretty easy move.
First house, we had nothing
now,
to speak of.
Now we've become mild hoarders.
It does.
So,
you know, I blame my kids for that.
Yeah, it is a problem. Yep.
Although I'm still trying to figure out why we still have close to 1,000 compact discs in the basement.
Right.
Seems like we could probably part with those.
Yeah. The other day I saw Nerf guns. I said, I'm pretty sure the kids have outgrown Nerf guns.
I think we're past the Nerf gun phase, yes.
Probably get rid of these. So we gave them away to someone. Hundreds of dollars worth of Nerf guns, I think. But anyway, that was all the rage at one point.
It really was. I used to find those Nerf darts all over my yard when I was mowing the grass. And I would shovel them up in the winter.
We bribed my son Liam with a high-velocity Nerf gun.
Ah, very
nice.
That's
how we got him to agree to allergy shots when he was a little kid.
Ah.
We'll get you the Nerf gun.
Liam is part of the Merrimack High School Tomahawk soccer group.
Yes, he is. And those allergy shots, worth their weight in gold, let me tell you. Smartest thing we ever did.
Looks like the fans are going to get ushered off the field from their soccer activities as Merrimack has their starting second half 11 coming out. Goffstown's team meeting just broke up. A little chant.
Well, got another 40 minutes here to see if we can resolve this thing. If we should go into overtime, my understanding is that it is, I believe, two 10-minute periods.
Okay.
And I believe the first, I could be totally wrong here, but I believe the first period is not golden goal, but the second period is.
Okay.
Which seems odd, so I could be completely off on that. But
do they need to go into playoffs to solve or overtime to solve a playoffs scenario? Or?
They do, yeah. Playoffs, you play until somebody's going to win.
Because they can have a tie throughout the season.
Yes, right.
Okay,
so if they play the two overtimes, if at the end of those two 10-minute overtimes it's still tied, goes in the books as a tie.
All right, so we're
– But hopefully
– We're looking to have –
That does not occur tonight.
A non-tie, because then it's going to get really cold if we go into the two overtime periods.
Yeah, we don't want that. The tie is – Nobody wins with a tie, Mark.
That
Nobody wins with a tie.
And will they go into PKs if it's still a draw at the end of the second overtime?
I think
overtime?
In the playoffs they will.
Yeah.
But not in
which is just
not,
a
not here.
Tragic way to end a game.
Yeah, it's like ending a basketball game with free throws.
Yeah.
It's just silly. Now when I played, I believe they would end the game with a breakaway. There'd be like a breakaway.
Okay.
You were given a certain amount, the goalie would be in there, player was given a breakaway. It'd be almost like in hockey.
In hockey, yeah, one-on-one style breakaway.
Because I remember practicing that in high school. But that was a long, long time ago, over 30 years ago.
In a galaxy far, far away?
Yeah, well, Manchester. So
not that far away.
Sometimes it feels like it's a galaxy far away.
Just about ready for second half action.
My hometown has changed quite a bit in the last 30 years.
I was just in my hometown, and it has not changed at all in
where's that?
50 years. I grew up in Maynard, Massachusetts.
Ah, I am not familiar.
That was the headquarters of the former Digital Equipment Corporation.
Oh, Digital had an office right here in Merrimack.
Yes, they did.
Which Fidelity purchased.
Currently occupied by Fidelity. Yeah, yep. We had Digital had 5 or 6 very large buildings in town, including an old cotton mill. And when they fell apart, the town kind of became a ghost town for a little while.
That's pretty sad when that happens.
We're into the second half now, 40 minutes remaining to see if we can get a decision on this game. Merrimack now attacking from right to left on your screen in their home blues. Goffstown from left to right in their away whites. Merrimack with an opportunity there, finally broken up by Goffstown.
I thought we might have something there.
That looked like it had some promise to it.
And some little hustle up front there. Oh, a little miscue there.
And Merrimack pushing forward now with some numbers. Goffstown's got a lot of defenders back, though. Oh, and there's a tester. That ball wide, but keeper taking no chances and pounces on that one. Punt goes out to about half field, pushed forward by Merrimack. Not sure what Coach Mursad had to say to them during halftime, but he seems to have lit a fire in their step.
They seem to have a little more spring in their step, don't they?
And Merrimack's defenders dropping back now as that ball goes out for a Merrimack throw. That ball pushed forward to half field by Tobias Werner, trying to find Ben Basoli. CJ Fricano steps into that one quickly, breaks up that play. And we're going to get a foul on Goffstown for a Merrimack kick.
Wow, that was a I guess he was playing advantage there. He was letting them move forward with the play. But
briefly played advantage, but yes.
Yeah.
He turned it around for the kick. Tobias Werner sends that one forward. It's a low ball, skips in the wet grass. Goes Nathan Johnson for Merrimack, trying to make that cross in. One of his early touches for the game. And got a bit of a crowd trying to bring that ball down. Merrimack with not enough space to turn the corner here. And now they're going to try to switch fields, it looks like. Oh, that touch a little too soft. Winds up at Goffstown's feet. And there's a good looking ball.
Oh, that is a nice ball.
Nicely weighted. Tobias Werner able to get back in time. And can't quite turn it around. Manages to do so at the last possible second and clears that out.
A couple of scary moments there for
very tense
Merrimack
moments.
Defense there.
Goffstown plays that backwards, trying to keep it in, and it's going to go out for a white throw, Goffstown. So some tense moments for both teams in the early action here in the second half.
Yeah, it's been back and forth, hasn't it?
That ball goes out for Goffstown throw, or are they calling that a handball? Nope, it's a throw. It was chested down by Nathan Johnson. Good. Boris Ramonovic taking that kick. That was a nice little juke move by Adrian Talbot to keep that play going. Ben Basoli now pushing forward. And he takes the shot.
Ooh.
Oh, tipped high and away by the
nice
goalie.
Shot.
I think
nice
that
save.
One was on frame.
That was a good shot.
That was
poked over the bar by the keep.
It was a great shot and a very good save by Goffstown's keeper.
That will bring about a corner.
Drew Flanders playing outside the box right now. That ball curls in, and that's going to go out on Goffstown. On Goffstown? No,
yeah,
they're
Goffstown.
Calling that out on Merrimack. I thought the Goffstown player touched it in the end, but not so much.
It's difficult to see. A lot of bodies moving around down there.
And anything on the far side of the field is even harder to see.
That's right.
Merrimack making a substitution now.
Yeah, it has cooled off significantly now, hasn't it?
It certainly feels colder than it did in the first half, yes. Tobias Werner trying to clear that one out, manages to get it over the sideline for a Goffstown throw-in. Ball's inbounded. Back to the thrower. And Goffstown trying to get that turned around. Another throw. Interesting cross by Goffstown, headed down by Merrimack and pushed out of bounds for a Merrimack goal kick. The town of Merrimack's media division is branded Merrimack TV. The division is funded by way of franchise fees from Comcast cable subscribers in Merrimack. The town of Merrimack has a community TV facility located at 6 Babusick Lake Road. Our three cable channels reach over 8,000 homes. We're accessible online at merrimacktv.com and on Roku and Apple TV devices via Cablecast ScreenWeave. Follow us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, stay informed. You're watching Merrimack TV.
You know, Mark.
Your community, your voice.
And this feels like the correct time to bring up the fact that Justin
did
have an assignment
last week.
Justin was
supposed to have a new slogan for us by this week.
Your community, your choice.
Your voice
is the existing one. And Justin did provide me with a new slogan.
Does he know that?
He said, Merrimack TV, watch us or we'll come to your house. That does not seem right to me, Mark.
As I said, does he know?
Well,
it's just a little wordy.
It's just a little wordy, is what I'm saying. I don't have a problem with the message. It's just a little wordy. Maybe watch us or else. Maybe that would be better. It fits on a T-shirt a little bit better.
That sounds more like the slogan for a Stallone movie or something.
Oh,
there's a chance ball.
I thought that was a little higher starting off.
Snatched out of the air by Goffstown's keeper.
I thought they had a chance to chip it over there.
There's a good-looking ball down the line for Goffstown coming up the right wing.
We have an initial order of 10 gross T-shirts, and we'll see how those go initially.
Merrimack manages to keep that one in, and now they're looking to get back on the attack.
They'll be available at the open house we mentioned earlier.
Yeah, don't forget that the open house for Merrimack TV is this Thursday, the 20th of October, and I believe it's from 5:30 to 8 p.m. right at the Town Hall, 6 Babusick Lake Road in scenic Merrimack.
Now, what can we expect to see at the studios, Justin, if we go there? Equipment.
Justin says equipment.
Equipment.
Yeah.
Justin, no offense, but I can see that at Best Buy, buddy.
Not like this, you can't.
Not like this. Not like this stuff. This is the good. This is the primo.
Best Buy is the amateur.
That's amateur
stuff.
Hour.
This is the professionals.
This is what the professionals use. That's right.
I mean, it's the professional equipment that they're using that allows us to bring you this live broadcast, and not only us.
Simulcast
on Goffstown TV.
Goffstown TV.
They're picking up the Merrimack feed and broadcasting that to their community. Ball's back at middle center field. Tobias sends that forward. Headed down by Goffstown, push forward. And that ball needs to find the carpet for somebody to regain possession and try to put something together. Here comes Goffstown, having done just that.
They don't have a lot of bodies forward. I mean, you can see there's...
That ball, nicely stolen.
Six guys back for Merrimack and three or four guys forward for Goffstown.
That was a great effort by Adrian Talbot, coming in to an unsuspecting Goffstown player to pluck that ball away. Daniel Sanchez chesting that one down. And looks like Daniel Kovarzhenko is going to take that throw for Merrimack. Oh, nice long throw. And that one turned back by Goffstown. Warner sprints forward, pushes that toward the box. A little too heavy a touch there. And keeper manages to keep that in and scoops it up. Merrimack tracking backward now, getting their defense ready. A punt out to midfield. Flick on header. Oh, this could be trouble.
This could be trouble. You're right.
And I can't find the room to pull the trigger on that ball. Well, this is... that ball mishit and cleared out of the box by Merrimack. And here they come. Goffstown with some pretty decent opportunities just now. That ball can't find Ben Basoli.
Yeah, the defender there on the initial run was just on his inside hip. He just couldn't get enough separation to be able to pull the trigger. I had to pull it back and cross it.
That cross... goes a bit astray. Adrian Talbot was calling for that one in the midfield. He had some space to work with, but they tried to cross it a little further than that. Just over 10 minutes into the second half. Merrimack 0, Goffstown 0. The Tomahawks and Grizzlies. That goal kick stays low, but gets as far as a Goffstown player who deflects it to midfield. Warner tries to settle it. And Merrimack draws the foul. And they're going to hold up the kick for a second for a Merrimack substitution. Tobias Werner planning to take that kick. Ben Basoli standing next to him as if it might go short, but it does not. That ball pops over the head of both Merrimack and Goffstown players trying to scoop it up. Goffstown on a breakaway now. They slow up. Goffstown still with the ball. Merrimack with a lot of numbers back, and that ball's broken up. It was an excellent play by Caden Martin for Merrimack.
Oh, that's a nice ball
trouble
right there.
Shot and scooped up by Drew Flanders.
I think the Goffstown player might have pulled the trigger a little early there.
Looked like he didn't get the piece of it that he wanted. Daniel sending that ball forward. Took a weird bounce. Got Merrimack player in the face. Seems none worse for the wear. Tobias heads that one. And pops it up. Goffstown recovers. Merrimack recovers that one. Both teams battling it out at midfield now. Merrimack player goes down. Goffstown player showing some good sportsmanship. Helping him get up. Ball coming down the wing for Goffstown. This could be some trouble. Nope, broken up by Ben Basoli. And another Merrimack substitution taking place. Merrimack throw, recovered by Goffstown, broken up by Merrimack. That ball pushed forward. That could have spelled some trouble, but Goffstown pushes that one sky high as they try to clear it out, and now they get past midfield. Merrimack's got some space here. And they push that one forward. A little miscommunication by Merrimack just now. That was Caden Martin looking for C.J. Fricano, but the ball was just a little bit behind him.
I think C.J. had anticipated a play down the line.
I think he did, yeah.
He already left. It's a good idea, just different page.
And Daniel plays it all the way back to the keeper. And Drew Flanders opts not to pick it up, pushes it out past midfield. And is touched by Goffstown. Merrimack trying to settle and turn the corner. C.J. Fricano didn't get the touch on that he expected. And he sends that one into the box. Pushed out by Goffstown. C.J. back on it. And here's an opportunity for Merrimack. Caden Martin trying to make something happen in the box. Goffstown breaks it up.
Approaching the halfway point through the second half.
Looks like you got two subs for Goffstown, one more sub for Merrimack. Temperatures dropped another 2 degrees. We're down to 52 on this very clear night after a very wet morning.
Yeah, and that cleared up. It was turned beautiful for a while there, didn't it?
Yeah, it looks like the next few days are going to be quite nice here in southern New Hampshire. C.J. Fricano with a little bit of space, plays it back into the middle. Goffstown doing a good job defending as Merrimack tries to push forward. Daniel sends that into the box. Headed out by Goffstown. Merrimack recovers, and they're looking to turn it around. Goffstown trying to get rid of that ball now. It's going to go out for a Merrimack throw. Well, that ball pushed way forward. Merrimack with only a couple of guys forward. Big opportunity. Oh, just wide. The shot by C.J. Fricano. He wants that one back.
That had some promise.
That was a nice build-up by Merrimack. Last year, Merrimack TV won two awards from the Alliance for Community Media Northeast Region. Our staff and volunteers placed second in the sports coverage category and was awarded first place for community media promotional videos. The Northeast region includes all of New England plus New York State. Thank you for supporting Merrimack TV. That's a pretty big region, all of New England and New York State.
That's a big footprint.
That's some great accomplishments by Merrimack TV. And now's a good time to say hello to our friends at Goffstown TV who are also broadcasting this game. We appreciate them doing that for their community and sharing the fine work of Merrimack TV on their own network so that the folks of Goffstown can see this game live as well. Merrimack pushing forward now. Oh, a little too heavy a touch. C.J. Fricano unable to get there, but Merrimack looking a little bit promising right now as we approach the halfway point in this second half. Got a Goffstown sub coming on now. That was David Philippi heading off. And Merrimack pops that one out. That was Daniel pushing that out for a Goffstown throw. Merrimack dropping back. C.J. Fricano trying to defend. Short throw. Broken up by Merrimack. Manages to keep it in bounds. Some very fancy footwork by
Adrian Talbot.
Adrian Talbot again, yeah. Goffstown with an opportunity here. Ben Basoli steps in. Doesn't make the tackle he expected. And they're going to call that a Merrimack ball. And if you're listening at home, I got the times of the open house for Community Media Day slightly wrong. I just noticed that it's 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. The address was correct, 6 Babusick Lake Road. The station was correct, Merrimack TV. Oh, that's a chance ball. Nobody forward to connect with that one, unfortunately. So again, that's 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. in the Merrimack TV studio for Community Media Day. This Thursday, October 20th. A couple of substitutes for Goffstown. We've got about 19 minutes remaining in this game. As Andrew and I were discussing at halftime, if it needs to go into overtime for playoff implications, we believe it's going to be two 10-minute overtime periods. And then if it's still a tie, it goes to the dreaded penalty kick decisions.
Well, not yet. Once the playoffs start, it'll go to penalty kick decisions.
But oh, okay.
Since this is a regular season game, it would just end in a tie.
So how do they determine playoff berth at that point?
I'm guessing it's you get 1 point for a tie, 3 points for a win, and whoever gets the most points goes to the playoffs.
Got it. I thought maybe they were tied in points, but I guess they could look at goal differential anyway.
Yeah, I think that, I'm not sure what they do. If you have the same amount of points, I'm not sure if it goes to goal differential at
Merrimack
that point.
Really applying the pressure now. Broken up by Goffstown, that ball unfortunately right behind C.J. Fricano, and that ball easily scooped up by the keeper, plucked out of the air, I should say. Yeah, the the approach is a little bit different in high school soccer than it is in the pros and international play. So including the two ref system, which is very unusual.
Ooh. Ooh, that's a penalty.
That is definitely a foul. Daniel taking the brunt of that hit. It was number 10, taking out number 10.
I think that's number 20, though.
Oh, was it 20 for Merrimack?
Yeah, I think it's 20 for Merrimack.
My apologies. That's Nathan Johnson then, not Daniel. But it was number 10 from Goffstown, Hunter White. Adrian Talbot plays back to his defender, who pushes it way forward. That defender was Daniel, number 10. Or no, that was number 11. Gosh, it's really hard to see from up here. That was Quinn Giuliano. Both teams playing with a bit more urgency now than they had been toward the end of the first half.
Yeah, we're approaching that 15-minute mark, so.
Goffstown substitution, Merrimack to take the throw. That ball headed back into play for Merrimack. Nathan Johnson with the header. That ball comes all the way toward the end line, and yeah, it goes out for a goal kick. Another Goffstown sub, another Merrimack sub. They're really rotating them in and out now, trying to put something together in these final minutes. Drew Flanders ready to take the kick. He goes short. Tobias Werner sends that ball to midfield. Nice little flick-on pass. Didn't quite get where they wanted it to go. Merrimack dropping numbers back now as Goffstown's got a throw in, taken short. And they're going to call out a foul on Merrimack. Got a direct kick for Goffstown. Referee pointing to the spot where he wants the ball. Goffstown pushing forward, Merrimack dropping back.
Ref calling pretty tight tonight, but you know, seems like consistent, so. No real complaints there, as long as it's called consistently. That's the key.
Quinn creating a one-man wall. Goes over his head. Pushed way forward by Merrimack. Looking for Caden Martin, unable to find him.
And that ball just hopped up and hit his hand.
Lots of words of encouragement from the Merrimack stands. Goffstown, nice inbounding ball. Oh, that could have been trouble.
It could have been.
That ball right into the box, close to the six, and unable to find the head of a Goffstown player. Drew Flanders to take the goal kick. Becoming a high school sports official is an easy call. Officiating allows you to continue to be a role model by demonstrating qualities such as impartiality, fairness, and courage. High school sports officials help protect the integrity of the games we love by teaching and enforcing the rules of play. New officials have an opportunity to make a difference in their communities right away. To learn more about becoming a high school sports official, please visit www.nhiaa.org.
Now, on that last play, you fans at home may be wondering, why was Drew allowed to pick up the ball on that, where Tobias played it back to him? It was, I believe the ref deemed it to be inadvertent. So if the ball gets played back to the goalie inadvertently, or by the head or other part of the body, that's okay. Or by it can't be kicked back.
Correct.
Intentionally. So I believe Tobias probably hit that. I think it was like his thigh. And so that is allowed.
Yes,
so Drew
it is.
Could pick that up.
But the intentional pass back to the goalie, as you indicated, not allowed.
Forbidden.
Although that has not always been the case.
Nope. Used to play back all the time.
My father was playing for West Point back in the 60s. They had a goalie with an incredibly strong arm. So they would pass back to the goalie, and he would throw it into the other team's box.
No kidding. Wow, that's nuts. Yeah, I think that rule changed somewhere like 1991.
Oh, there's a good ball.
Something
nice
like that.
Nice attempt. Very nice attempt by Merrimack.
In New Hampshire high school sports. NCAA sports, I think.
Caden Martin with the cross. Could have curled in, but the goalie was there to snatch it out of the air. Tobias takes a bump as he goes up for the header. We're going to call that a foul and a Merrimack kick. Just a little bit more than 10 minutes remain here in the second half. A ball from Tobias skips forward into the box, and Goffstown's goalkeeper is going to scoop that up. Punt out to half field. And yeah. That header is the Tobias returning the favor of getting bumped on a header. So it's going to be a Goffstown kick.
I think he felt like he didn't collide with him there, but I don't think he went straight up. I think that's probably a good – I think that's consistent with what the ref's been calling tonight. So
absolutely.
I think that was a good call. And you know, I've seen that go uncalled, but – but tonight he's calling it pretty tight, and that's fine.
It's a good call. Tobias heads that one out of the box. CJ Furcano pops it forward, trying to get it forward to himself, but a little too heavy a touch. Merrimack trying to build something up now. That was Quinn Giuliano.
10 minutes now.
Got a foul on Goffstown now.
It's going to be a dangerous spot here if he lofts it into the box. And
Isaiah Traverso to take the kick.
Guys.
And I don't think he got the piece of that he wanted, but a nice heel flick. Gets it toward the box. And Merrimack with a real possibility there.
Yeah, that heel flick was nice, wasn't it?
There's Tobias. A little bit of space. One touch too many. Gets
nice tackle.
Stripped off. And Basoli covers defense while Tobias drops back. And Merrimack with a little space to try to figure out how they're going to get this ball up the field now. That's a good ball. A little too heavy a touch on the pass into the corner. And ball stays in. Goffstown manages to turn it around. But that's going to go out for a Merrimack throw pretty close to their own bench.
Just under 8 minutes now. I don't believe there's any stoppage time.
Throw whistled back now for three substitutes coming on for Goffstown. So Merrimack to take the throw again. There's a nice through ball for Merrimack. And the shot right into the midst of Goffstown's keeper.
Yeah, that was a nice ball, though.
That was a really nice ball setting up that shot.
Nice weight to it. Just kind of sat there for him.
Goffstown with some space. CJ for Connor. Nope, sorry, that wasn't CJ. CJ's on the near side. Merrimack making a nuisance of himself, trying to keep that ball in the Goffstown end. Goffstown over the ball at half field now. And that pass goes to Merrimack. Pushed forward, broken up by Goffstown, and here they come. Goffstown sending more numbers before than they were in the first half, Andrew. You had commented they only had one or two at the time.
Yeah, they do. They
now they've got a 4 or 5. Merrimack throw into the box, and that ball curves away from the goal and over for a goal kick.
We are ticking down the mystical 5 minutes, as we call it, Mark. That point where the clock turns off and it's anybody's guess how much time remains.
Mystery time.
The mystery 5 minutes.
It's the magical mystery tour of soccer. Ball spends a lot of time in the air tonight in this game.
Here's a big opportunity.
Oh. Broken up, but not cleared. Drew Flanders pushes that one away. Goffstown's still on the attack, unleashes, and Drew with a diving save.
Goffstown's not going to get a better chance than that. I suspect they won't get a better chance than that tonight.
That was a very dangerous sequence. I think they're going to call Merrimack on the high boot on that play. But Drew Flanders springing into action on that play.
Yeah. Answered the call, as it were.
And we are into the 5 minutes of stopped clock where the officials keep the time.
But luckily for you folks at home, Mark has his own watch going tonight.
Yes, I do.
And he will keep us apprised of the time that remains.
Got about 4 minutes and 15 seconds remaining, plus any stoppage. But as Andrew indicated, there probably won't be any. There haven't been any real delays in play here.
It's been a pretty clean game. There haven't been any major fouls, no major injuries.
Oh, here comes Merrimack trying to put something together. Got numbers forward, headed out of the box by Goffstown.
End to end we go.
Those low headers make me nervous when people lean down like that.
Yeah.
You just never know when a boot is coming up to find that ball.
I always say just run through the ball.
Absolutely.
Don't try and low head it.
Absolutely.
My brother-in-law had a kid on his team who went for a low header and ended up with broken nose and two black eyes. So.
Oh, the shot ricochets off of Goffstown. Did hit his arm, but it was in a natural position, so it's not a handball. Merrimack still trying to find a handle on this thing. Goffstown scrambling. And that ball pushed forward, but goes wide.
Yeah, just any time you put your head down there where someone's foot.
Yeah, which is
why very easily come up here.
I get a little uncomfortable when
you're taking a chance.
When guys go to ground unnecessarily as well, because there's a good chance you're going to get a boot or stepped on.
Yeah, but at least when you go to ground, you're coming in such a way that
you're not as vulnerable.
Yeah, it's just when you go for one of those low headers, you're basically just sticking your head.
It's kind of like putting a golf ball on a tee at that point.
Yeah, you're just sticking your head out there like. Now, it's only out there for a short period of time, but in that moment, you are about as exposed as you get.
If you're going to do it, you better know your surroundings. You better know exactly where every player is in your vicinity. So,
but if you have that much time,
don't do it.
If you have that much time, you probably don't need to do it.
Not to mention, if you use your body's bigger than your head. You can push that ball and drop it to your feet.
Yeah. It doesn't look as cool, though, Mark.
It does not.
Doesn't look nearly as cool.
I'll give you that. Just about 2 minutes remaining. And then we'll see what happens in terms of any overtime. CJ Furcano trying to find that one. Pushed away and out of bounds for a Merrimack throw.
What are we looking for time now, Mark?
Just under two.
Wow. Time flies, doesn't it?
Time flies when you're freezing cold atop the stadium. Merrimack still trying to find a way in. Another throw. And a minute and a half, roughly. Big opportunity here. Space for the shot. Shot unleashed.
Oh, my.
The goalie for Goffstown taking no chances. Dives to his right.
It looked pretty close from up here, although.
He did not make contact in the ball. Went away on its own.
Yeah. But I think it was probably about a yard outside.
Yard is about right.
But it was a strong shot.
Goal kick sent to midfield, headed down by Merrimack, popped up high by Goffstown.
I'm guessing there's probably a minute left right now.
You're pretty close, yes. So we are in our final seconds here. Merrimack applying a lot of pressure in this final few minutes.
A lot of pressure from Merrimack.
And Goffstown trying to find some relief, and they send that out instead of down for an attack. It's going to be a Merrimack throw, pretty much even with the Merrimack bench on the far side of the field. Nice play by Daniel, chesting it to his own foot, turning the corner. And Goffstown trying to connect now. It's going to be a foul on Goffstown for a Merrimack kick. And the final seconds are definitely waning here. We should see full time any second now. Of course, now we get a little bit of stoppage as they try to retrieve the ball for the throw-in and goes too far into the field.
I would guess that this is probably going to, as soon as this play comes to a conclusion, this clock is probably out. So.
I wouldn't be surprised if once the ball is struck.
Well, he's not even going to
get struck.
Strike the ball.
So we're at the end of.
Tobias is incredulous.
End of regulation time here.
Tobias not understanding.
Tobias still
where
waiting.
Where is everybody going?
Tobias still waiting to take a kick. So we're at the end of regulation. Goffstown nil. Merrimack nil.
Oh, and Tobias just got a yellow card for his.
Gets a caution for dissent.
Questioning. But I, so anyone who's ever watched professional soccer will know that you would never have a half end that way, right? And I think that's pretty much what Toby was questioning. And so in a professional game that kids would watch on TV, you'll always have that last play.
Yeah,
they would never stop it on a dead ball like that.
I definitely expected him to strike the ball and
then
the whistle go immediately.
Yeah,
so
the
fact that they blew it beforehand is almost irrelevant because there was going to be no build-up and no opportunity
to play together.
Right,
the likelihood of something good happening for Merrimack there was.
So they take a 5-minute lull in the activity.
But I have heard that in the high school game that the rules from NHIA – is it NHIA?
NHIIA?
Anyway.
It's in my notes because
they
talked about being a ref.
They tell the refs to stop the game exactly.
Oh, NHIAA.
I had it right, for God's sake.
Well, I didn't hear the second A. I thought you just had one A.
I did say one A, and then I covered myself by mumbling several different derivations.
I see.
Yes. But, Yeah, I think the instruction that the refs receive is to end it right when their watch hits whatever added time. It ends right there. It doesn't matter what the status of the ball is at that point. So I don't particularly like that rule, but that's my opinion.
There are some subtle differences, and it's hard to acclimate to some of them.
So we head into overtime with it looks like they're going to give them about another 3 minutes to prepare themselves. And then I suspect we will have 2 10-minute periods. Although I'm not entirely sure how the golden goal works.
Andrew, do you know what NHIAA stands for?
New Hampshire? I'm going to take a guess. New Hampshire Interscholastic Association.
So close. So close. You were very close. New Hampshire Interscholastic Athletics Association.
Oh, yes. Yes, Athletics Association. That makes a little more sense.
You were missing the key word, the athletics.
You ever see that movie Dodgeball when they say...
Yes.
I don't exactly remember what it was, but I know it repeats itself. They have one word twice in the acronym.
It has been way too long since I have seen that movie. I do not recall.
I watched Semi-Pro the other day. Maybe the most underrated sports comedy of all time.
I've never even heard of it.
Of all time. Oh, so you never heard of Semi-Pro?
No, sir.
Oh, I endorse that movie wholeheartedly. It is a winner, Will Ferrell.
Oh, you lost me. I'm done.
You're not a fan?
Not a Will Ferrell fan.
He's excellent in Semi-Pro.
I find that hard to believe.
It is absolutely true. How dare you, sir? How dare you? Will, if you're watching out there, don't pay any attention. You were brilliant in that movie. I laughed so hard I cried.
I tend to cry when I see him as well.
Oh, good gravy. You are so old.
It's just not my brand of comedy.
Oh, Mr. What are you, one of these Monty Python guys?
I have been known to enjoy the Monty Python gentleman.
Oh, God. That's okay. We'll agree to disagree on this one. Monty Python can be funny, by the way. I don't mean to disparage Monty Python. We are just about ready to get going here. Actually, they're probably all... God, they're all men now, aren't they? Monty Python, they're probably...
Those that are still alive,
so,
yes.
Yeah, jeez. John Cleese was a very, very funny guy.
I don't know if we had camera coverage, but some of the guys coming off the field running and sliding on their sneakers, so that should give you... And going about... 7 or 8 yards, so that should give you an idea of how slick the conditions are
now. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me too much.
And we're just about ready. Ooh, giant moth just flew through.
Seems a little cool for moths to be flying about.
I would think they'd be up near the warm lights instead of down here. All right, so we're ready for the first overtime action here. Both teams taking the field. 10 minutes of play. And as we get started with this first overtime period, we'd again like to say thank you to Goffstown TV for carrying this game along with Merrimack TV. The cooperation between local stations is a big part of the program and the large area that I mentioned earlier, all of New England and New York.
A large footprint.
So if your team is playing away, you might check out Merrimack TV and see if they're broadcasting the game. That ball skied up by Goffstown.
Now Merrimack really seemed to be taking it to Goffstown in the waning moments of regular time, so we'll see.
They did. Right at the start of the five, Goffstown had their big opportunity, and then Merrimack turned it around. And yeah, they were really pressuring hard, so we'll see
if Merrimack can
see how they come out. Right now, it's been a lot of Goffstown action. Going to be a Goffstown throw. No, I'm sorry. Goffstown kick. Foul called on Merrimack. Goffstown with a lot of numbers in the box now.
Yeah, these set pieces late in the game, pretty dangerous.
It's a good ball into the box. It's headed high by Tobias.
Little element, added element.
Forward by Goffstown.
Little element of added desperation late in the game. It seems like you have more happen late.
It does seem like set pieces become more dangerous late in the game. And right now, especially with the dew buildup on the grass and how slick it is, could present a real problem.
And the offensive team just takes more chances. You know, they play more guys forward. There's just more.
Yep.
There's just that urgency that you don't really have later in the game. Earlier in the game, rather.
Goffstown's throw. Broken up by Merrimack. Goffstown regains possession. Daniel Sanchez involved in that action, trying to find a handle on the ball. It's going to be over for a Goffstown throw. That ball headed down.
A little bit of a shove there. Again, definitely calling it tight tonight, but consistently tight, so that's good. Ooh,
some tense moments for Goffstown right there.
Yeah,
that ball
absolutely
had the opportunity to pop in to the box, and that could have spelled some real trouble for Goffstown.
Yeah. You get the feeling, you know, this may end on, you know, hopefully it doesn't end on some defensive mistake, but it's back and forth so much that you know, you wonder if something's just going to slip through and give an opportunity.
And both teams, obviously, after 80 minutes of play, starting to feel some fatigue.
Yeah.
It was a good searching ball by Goffstown, headed away by Tobias Werner, out for Goffstown throw.
You just get teams that get a little more aggressive. You know, sometimes the counterpunch works, counterattack works a little better, you know, because.
Risky ball, cleaned up by Goffstown. And Merrimack grabs that one, and here they come. Nice pass.
Merrimack's building here.
Merrimack unable to get it into the box. Still trying to build something up. Daniel with a rip from way outside, and that curls toward the top corner, but goes just wide. Got some cowbells going on down in the stands now.
Yeah, some noisemakers.
Somebody should have brought their vuvuzela.
Didn't they ban those? Aren't those
they did ban
internationally
them
banned
They
now?
Banned them at World Cup games, that is for certain.
So I remember those
World Cup in South Africa.
There was one
deafening.
World Cup where it was just unbelievable.
Yeah. It was so loud, in fact, that you could basically not hear the commentators. And, you know, maybe some of you at home are thinking that's a good idea now.
Careful, Mark. There'll be a run on vuvuzelas.
Drown out me and Andrew, and suddenly, yes.
Vuvuzela, is that, that sounds made up.
It is not. It is not.
Does it mean something in some other language?
Well, I believe they were the World Cup was in South Africa, and I believe it is a tribal horn of sorts. And I don't remember if they were used for the hunt or for communication.
I'm guessing today's vuvuzela is a little bit of a different animal.
They were all plastic, yes.
Yes. I'm guessing that the tribes did not use plastic fluorescent yellow.
I do not believe they did, no.
Vuvuzelas.
Now I'm inspired to see if I can order a vuvuzela on Amazon.com.
It's a big tackle.
I don't need one.
A lot of green in front here.
Oh, that ball well broken up by Merrimack. Tracking back.
It's Isaiah.
It is. Isaiah Traverso. Showing some speed even in this late action. We're at 4 minutes remaining. Thanks for watching today's event on Merrimack TV. If you're interested in learning more about Merrimack TV, email Nicholas and Justin at MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov. Again, that's MerrimackTV@MerrimackNH.gov.
Mark, I've noticed something.
What is that, Andrew?
The mystical 5 minutes.
Does not apply in overtime.
Maybe. Or maybe someone is just
Well, if you think about
forgotten.
It, that would be half of the overtime
it
period.
It would be half.
So that seems
but still.
A little excessive.
Still, it seems you have the same controversy with people looking at the clock and saying, oh, it should be over. Maybe they'll stop it at two. I would think two would be reasonable.
Yeah. Percentage-wise, that seems about right.
One-fifth of the...
20%, 20... yeah.
One-eighth versus one-fifth, but...
Well, we'll find out in about 45 seconds. Merrimack trying to build something up now.
And if not, it will remain
Goffstown.
One of life's little mysteries, Mark.
Yes. Yes, it will. Perhaps someday physicists will unravel the meaning of the universe and the clock ticking in high school soccer. Merrimack pushes the ball into the box, headed only as far as a Merrimack player.
Oh, boy. Oh!
Didn't have the room to pull his leg around on that one the way he wanted to. Ben Basoli with the attempted shot. Merrimack still on the attack here.
Adrian
Talbot
looking
for the turn. Oh, and a shot from outside. And that's going to go out for a goal kick. And
we have
stopped
at the mystical 2 minutes. Oh, boy.
And there was much rejoicing that now we know the answer.
So let it be said, so let it be done.
That first 8 minutes went by very quick for us. I'm sure the players might disagree. Some tense moments and some tired legs out there.
Now, Mark, did you remember to set your clock?
Andrew, I did.
Excellent.
For 10 minutes, not 40.
Good.
That ball stays in bounds.
Yeah, you definitely seen some tired legs out there.
Yes.
You've seen guys overrun the ball.
Merrimack breaking that up and regrouping a little.
Good pass out.
Daniel over the ball now. And we're inside of a minute remaining now.
That was a good tackle.
In this first period of overtime. Tobias didn't get the piece of that he wanted.
Stepping in there, ball twists away into the stands.
Into the stands. And got a very fast ball boy retrieving that.
Careful, ball boy, careful.
We know what can happen. The expression ball boy down was born in this very stadium last year.
Colby Chasen, the original ball boy down. Yeah.
Merrimack throw. Final seconds ticking here.
I'm guessing there's probably less than a minute here, right, Mark?
We got about 10 seconds, Andrew.
Ooh, a lot less than a minute.
That ball pushed forward, chested by Goffstown. And they're trying to put something together now. And that's going to be a foul on Merrimack. And we should be just at about full time. We'll see if they get to take the kick or if it ends the way the second half did.
You better hurry, boys, or else you're...
We should be at full time.
We should.
Kick comes in. Oh, that's a shot. And Drew Flanders pounces on that one.
Wow.
And that's going to be the end of the action in the first half.
I'm wondering why we didn't get a whistle on that.
Overtime.
That kick there, but
so both
anyway.
Both teams regroup now. And
Drew a little shaken up there. I think he may.
He does look a little
taking a little
worse for the wear.
A little chuck there at the end.
Yeah, I don't.
I believe we have progressed into golden goal territory now.
So we.
But I could be wrong.
They've now played 90 minutes, which is a regulation game in college and pros.
These final 10 minutes. It ends in a tie. If no goal is scored, we will end in a tie. Both teams with some good opportunities tonight, but unable to put it in the back of the net.
That is true. Lots of opportunities toward the end of the first half and quite a few just now in the first overtime period. Teams huddling up, trying to figure out how to put this one away. Still a good crowd on hand here. Looks like we've got a lot of Merrimack travel soccer players here from the younger grades. Fair amount of blue in the stands over here.
Yep.
And Goffstown taking the field now. Merrimack still huddled up. Here they come. Teams changing sides.
Tired legs out there now.
No doubt. Stands really erupting now for Merrimack.
Crowd's letting them hear it.
Both teams playing their hearts out tonight. And just about ready here. And we're underway. I don't think Toby has got the purchase on that one that he wanted. That one kind of shanked.
Ball was jumping a little bit when it got to him, I think. Middle of the field is pretty chewed up there.
It is, yes.
Ball takes some weird little bounces. Merrimack's got something going here.
Broken up by Goffstown, but they weren't able to clear it first. Now they get it out toward midfield. Not a lot of numbers forward for Goffstown, but Merrimack sprinting back now on defense. Goffstown lays that one out to the wing. The attack continues right near the top of the box. That ball crossed into the box, and Drew Flanders
Goffstown's got
Johnny
five.
On the spot there. Leaping save.
Goffstown's keeping five guys back on that buildup there. They kept five guys way back there. It's almost like
it looked like a bit of a high boot there, but play continues. Conditions definitely getting slick as we watch Merrimack player go down.
And a Goffstown player just took a seat.
Toby is trying to find someone. Starting to build up. That ball overcooked a little bit. And that's a nice searching ball into the corner.
And I think we've got a corner here for Merrimack. With 8 minutes remaining.
Crowd is getting very enthusiastic, Andrew, and I have to wonder if they had that enthusiasm toward the end of the second half, if this game would have gone into overtime.
Well,
they could.
I don't know how much the crowd
spur the team
how
on.
How much control the crowd
well,
has?
Control,
over it.
No, but just some energy.
Yeah,
there's a nice curling
ball
energy. In.
You do get energy from the crowd. That is true.
As Brad Feldman for the Revs would say, right into the breadbasket of the keeper. It's Tobias over the ball. And that ball pushed deep into space, but nobody there. Got a foul on Merrimack.
I don't know about that.
And Goffstown pushing numbers forward now.
I know I've been saying they've been calling it tight, but that may be a little too tight.
And that ball, that's a squirrely ball. It looked like it was going right toward Drew's chest, and then it dropped to his feet. He had to go down unexpectedly for that one. And very high boot. Punt goes out past midfield. Headed by Goffstown. Merrimack struggling now to turn the tides here. And they just can't seem to find a handle.
Ooh, we got a player down.
That player got hit in a region where players don't want to get hit with a pretty powerful boot. He is very slow to get up. He's regained his feet, which is good to see. He's going to try to walk that one off. Big punt from Goffstown's goalie. It's Adrian Talbot trying to push the ball forward. And that's going to go out for a Merrimack kick.
Throw in.
Yeah. Yes. It's late in the action.
I understand.
Their legs are tired.
Mark.
And you're tired, Mark.
Yes, exactly. I'm hungry.
I am very hungry.
I could use a meal.
And here comes
Goffstown. A lot of green.
Oh, dangerous ball. Warner's got to get on his horse here. Manages to turn it outside. And it's going to go out for a Goffstown throw. Just about halfway through the second half of stoppage, or overtime rather. As we get closer to the end of the game, once again, we'd like to thank Goffstown TV for broadcasting tonight's game and their community as well.
Now the Goffstown fans making noise, and the Merrimack fans in response.
Oh, there's a tough ball.
Some crazy action at the mouth.
Crazy action at the mouth of the goal.
That was some crazy action at the mouth
of the goal. Ben Flanders able to get a paw on that one, but unable to clear it out completely. Goffstown crosses it in. And almost a frantic. And a Merrimack defender right off his chest was able to clear that out. And here comes Merrimack with a good through ball to C.J. Furcano. One load, and it goes just wide.
Oh, mamma mia. That was
well. This has been some of the most exciting action that we've seen tonight.
The last minute has been, man, that ball was so close. Bellissimo.
Both sets of bleachers here. People on their feet. People stomping on the bleachers to make some noise. So if your picture is jumping ever so slightly, I could feel the vibrations up here.
I haven't seen this much excitement since Ball Boy Down.
That is true. The roof of the press box where we're standing is shaking quite a bit. Goffstown's fans bringing it now as Goffstown tries to build up. Quick throw by Goffstown. Headed away by Warner.
At least from this angle, that last shot there by Merrimack was so close.
Merrimack unable to get rid of that. Goffstown trying to continue their attack, but broken up now by Merrimack. And I don't know if he's eaten dinner yet tonight, but I think Drew Flanders has earned his dinner.
Yeah, we'll let him eat tonight.
It's good to see that both of Drew's parents are here to watch
trouble.
This action. Another great save by Drew.
No soup for you.
And the Merrimack fans let
go
them know just how happy they are with that play. Both teams now playing with reckless abandon.
Oh, that's a
That's going to be a big foul on Goffstown. Thought maybe we'd see some plastic on that one, but the ref just wants to get play underway again. We're inside of 3 minutes remaining.
Now that may have even been a good foul for Goffstown, to be honest with you, because it stopped everything.
It's a good strategic foul. It gave them opportunities to get their entire team back. Good cross in. And here's a big opportunity for Goffstown now.
Oh, I don't know.
A little grabbing of the arm there. That's going to be a foul against Goffstown. That ball pushed forward. And Merrimack turns it around. Goffstown's goalie playing a high line right now. Now he's dropping back. Pass back to the keeper. And he kicks it away. And Goffstown unable to keep that in bounds. It's going to be a Merrimack throw.
We're ticking down to the mystical 2 minute mark.
Yes, we are. And there it is. 2 minutes remain now. Score remains 0-0. Merrimack looking to build up something here.
We've had two huge opportunities by both teams here tonight.
Out and grabs that one handily.
In the second overtime. Each team has had
some crazy action at either end. And here comes Merrimack. CJ Fricano trying to find a handle.
Oh, that's a penalty
That's definitely a foul.
That's a foul.
And the players don't seem to
acknowledge
the
whistle.
And looks like there's going to be a talking to here.
Yeah, he can't get him a card for that. The kid was excited. There's 2 minutes to go and double overtime 0-0.
I think he's getting his final warning of the evening.
Can't blame him.
Got some plastic issued here.
Oh, so that wasn't about the
I think that was dissent.
Something else going on out there.
Brody Reeves from Goffstown earning himself a yellow card.
Maybe something happened when they played that ball? I don't know.
Yeah, I'm sure there's some commentary that we can't hear that's going on down on the field. It's a good curling ball in by Merrimack.
That is a good ball.
The header just not there.
Oh,
and it's poked in but swatted away by Goffstown's goalie.
Was that his leg? I think he got his leg out there, didn't he?
It looked like his mitt to me.
Was it his mitt? Oh, come on. You got to call that.
It happened rather quickly.
That was a very obvious foul.
And I think we're going to see some more plastic.
I think we're going to see a yellow.
Yep. Another yellow card for Goffstown.
Yeah, I mean, you could see him holding him by the shirt there.
Boris Romanovich for Goffstown earning himself a yellow card.
But again,
three players in the book
tonight. I'm not even sure that's a bad foul, to be honest with you.
And we should be at full time now, although we've had a couple of clock stoppages for the issuing of the plastic awards.
I mean, there was definitely some momentum going there. The
final cross in.
Nobody home.
Merrimack turning. And the shot deflected.
A little Maradona going
scooped
there.
Scooped up. That, ref's looking at his watch. I think we're going to see the final seconds here.
Yeah,
they're letting it play. And here comes Goffstown with an opportunity. Broken up handily by Merrimack. I think they got a little bit lucky there.
That was looking
And
dangerous.
Here comes Merrimack. That ball goes out. Kind of expecting final whistle here.
Oh, boy.
Can't seem to find the room. And there it is.
Oh, good gravy.
We have a late, last-minute goal, by last-second goal.
That's got to be.
Drew Flanders sprinting the length of the field to congratulate his team. Goffstown's players a bit devastated. Goffstown's goalie on the ground,
Injected.
Another player on the ground. Merrimack takes this one in the second overtime in the very final seconds. As I mentioned, the ref was looking at his watch.
Drew Flanders
going
walking
over
up to the other team's goalie.
Console the other team's goalie. I like what I'm
Knows
seeing.
Knows how he feels.
It's great sportsmanship from Drew. It's a tough, heartbreaking loss for Goffstown. And what a great game by Merrimack.
That
unbelievable build-up in the final seconds. And that is your ball game.
Yeah, that's golden goal, right?
Yes,
golden
it is. Goal? Golden goal, and they're also out of time.
They're out of time anyway. So, yeah, it wouldn't really matter, would it?
Tough end for Goffstown, a brilliant end for Merrimack. Both teams playing.
Who got that? Who got that last
ball? It happened so quickly, I cannot tell you, Andrew. I wish I could.
I didn't think he was going to get it. I thought the angle was shut down.
Teams and, lining up to shake hands now.
But it snuck through.
So there's your final results, folks. Merrimack 1-0. Tomahawks 1, Goffstown Grizzlies 0. We'd like to thank you for watching tonight. Thank you for tuning in to Merrimack TV and to Goffstown TV. And a thanks to Goffstown TV as well for carrying this game. We wish you a pleasant evening and a good night.